Hello, my name's David, and in this video we're going to have a look at a filter which has got a bit of a surprise with it, and that surprise is it can produce a rather nice embossed painterly effect. Let's have a look at that filter. We're going to head down to Live Filters, and with the fly up menu I'm going to go to Lighting. Now I was using this on an image. This is the default, the spotlight, and while I was moving it round into position, going through the sliders, I came down to texture, a little bit intrigued, grabbed hold of it, moved it back and forth, and it's while I was moving it back and forth, I suddenly thought, wow, I like this embossed look. So I started trying some of the other sliders, and I came to type, and it's when I changed it from spot to point, pow, there is our painterly effect. It'd be better if I move this out of the way as well. But there it is. And I thought, that looks absolutely fantastic. Really works well. Now let's take a look at some of the sliders. Now distance. Keep an eye on this circle going right the way around the outside. And as I start to move this, that circle gets bigger or smaller. And it's a little bit like a vignette. It's darker on the outside than it is on the inside, where it's a lot lighter. So moving this back and forth, and I think there would suit the image. Come to the blue spot. You can adjust the central point. And as you move it, notice the way all the lineage is moving as well. I'm going to place it there. That'll do nicely. Let's take a look at some of the other sliders. Now, ambient, if we start to move this up and down, making it a little bit brighter. Shininess, let's just drop it down a touch or two. There, looks pretty good. Let's go to specular, and that's now on the inside of the shop. You can make it brighter. I'm going to make it a little bit darker. That will do nicely. So let's take a look at this texture. I'm going to just use spacebar. Now I'm going to use Command or Control. Let's zoom into this area. Notice the brickwork, the way the cement is behind that brickwork. If you come down to texture, if you take it in the opposite direction, we're now going to go to minus 100 pixels. And you can see we've now weathered our brickwork and it's gone behind our cement. So experiment, see which one works for your image, but I'm going to go with this particular image to the 100 pixels. Let's close this down. Command 0, Control 0, let's go to Fit on Screen. Let's take a look at it on another image, and I've selected this one of some merry men playing some instruments. Once again, we're going to head down to Live Filter. We're going to go to Lighting, and just moving it to the side. This time, we're not going to use Spot. No point, we're going to go to Directional, taking the texture right the way up. Coming to the little grab handle, start moving it around. I'm moving it around, it's got some really nice effects. Now this is taking the lighting in this direction here. If you come to this little blue spot, you can also grab, you can move this around. I'm going to take it into this position and just pulling it out slightly. You can see the way we can darken it down, move it in, you make it a bit brighter. I just want to bring through some of the clouds. Something like this looks pretty good. Let's come up to ambient. Let's take a look at this and move this back and forth, just dropping it down a little bit more, coming out of those clouds. Shininess, just a touch with that. Specular, just dropping that down a touch. Diffuse, didn't look at this before. What's this going to do? No, I'm going to keep that. Yeah, I'm going to keep that up at 100%. Talking of percentage, let's take a look. Texture, 100 pixels. Let's drop this down to minus 100. Let's take it back in the opposite direction. Do you know, I quite like it down there, but there's more. What if you want to increase the amount? Well, I'm just going to highlight the numbers. So we got minus, and I've just highlighted the 100. I'm going to put in 225, enter or return. And there it is. If it's a bit much, don't forget, it's experiment. See which one works for your image. I'm going to click on this, but with this, I'm going to reduce it as well. I'm going to take it into that area. I think that works really well with this image. What have we got? We got 686 pixels with this particular one. Some of the other things we got, specular color. Click in here. You see, it opens my HSL color wheel. Of course, use whichever slider that you're comfortable with. I'm going to go back with the color wheel. Let's move this to this into a color. We got red. Looks like it's on the clothing. Looks like it's in the sky as well. Let's grab hold of this. Let's move it around. Yes, it is. We can have whatever color we want. Go for a green, go into this sort of color. There, looks pretty good. And we can just change it a little bit more. Let's go for that. Right, let's have a look at the ambient light color. Click in here. Once again, there's my color wheel, just moving it. It looks like it is their faces, not unless they're just embarrassed. I'm going to leave it like that. Color, let's click and see what this is. It's the entire image. Right, I'm going to just pull this out into this area here, perhaps take it a little bit more. I just want a little bit of a touch of color with this particular one. Let's grab hold of it. And if we come into the greens, let's swing it round. I think this is going to look good in the blues there. Like the way that's looking, just come into the slider, the outside one, just moving it around. Just a little touch of blue. That looks pretty good. Happy with that. So there it is. Just click to close it. Save it as an Affinity file. Don't forget, it is a live filter, so you can always come back to it. You can always make any changes, any adjustments. But yeah, I like the way that's looking. Go on, give it a try. I hope you've enjoyed the video. Give it the thumbs up if you have. Don't forget to subscribe. Plenty more videos to come. Click that little bell icon. You'll receive a notification every time a new video is posted. But until the next time, it is happy imaging and take care.